how to multiply 998 and 985 with the techniques discussed in online lecture. Split and merge can also be used, in fact. Split and merge can also be used, but your choice, I mean, whichever is comfortable for you. What do we have to do? 998 into 985. If you have to use split and merge, what do you do? 998 can be taken as 1000 minus 2 into 985. So what happens? 985 into 1000 is 985,000 straight. Minus 985 into 2. How much is 985 into 2? 900 to 1800. 85 into 2, 170. So 1970. So basically 985,000 minus 2000. So 983,000 plus 30. It's not 2000, right? It's 1970. So 983,030 would be the answer. Right? There's one more way of doing it. I mean, this is split and merge. This is using split and merge, like somebody had selected, right? Let's go for split and merge. So using split and merge, you can do this. What's the other way of doing it? Both the numbers, if you observe, 998 and 985 are closer to 1000. 998 and 985. I am not going to explain this technique in detail. You can watch the speed math video. But based on that technique, what happens? Very simple. 998 is 2 less than 1000. 985 is 15 less than 1000. So take the difference, I mean, take the distance of the values from 1000. We are taking the base as 1000, right? Considering the base as 1000, what do we find? 998 is 1000 minus 2. 985 is 1000 minus 15. Now you have to just take, you know, either 998 minus 15, 983, or 985 minus 2, 983. You understand? 985 minus 2 is 983, or 988 minus 15 is also 983. Then there will be three zeros, because the base is 1000, will be three zeros. Plus how much? See, product of these two. Minus 2 into minus 15 is what? Plus 30. So add 30. So your answer will be 983030. You're getting it? Very easy to apply. Very easy to apply when the numbers are both close to 1000 or both close to 100 or close to 10,000 and so on. So you can use any method. I mean, either of these two methods, depending on what is comfortable for you and depending on what you can apply easily, right? It's your choice always. Okay, so you must know how to get 45% of a given value, right? 45% of any value, 50% minus 5%. So do that now. So basically 50% minus 5% will result in 162 here. 162 plus 288. Again, quickly split and add. 100 and 200 is 300, 60 and 80 is 140, 2 and 8 is 10. So 300 plus 140, 440 plus 10, 450. Right? Or maybe you can say 2 plus 8 is 10. So you can actually bring this 2 here. So 288 will become 290. 290 plus 160. 290 plus 160. So 290 plus 100 is 390 plus 60 is 450. So left hand side is 450. 450 is what percent of 750? Again, don't do all this nonsense here. Like 450 equals to, let's assume X percent. So X by 100 into 750. Then 0 and 0 cancel, then 5 into 15, 5 into 2, then 15 into 1, 15 into 30, then 30 into 2 is equal to 60. Answer is correct. 60 is the answer. But what you have done is crap. You can't be doing this in the exam. So what do you do now? 450 is what percentage of 750 is the question. If you are capable of finding out the value of this question mark here without putting pen on paper, then you are ready for this exam. Otherwise, you have to work hard. How do you do this? See, you know that 10% of 750 is 75. 10% is 75. Yes or no? 10% is 75. But this is not 75. This is 450. So try and see if it comes out to be a multiple of 75. You getting it? Now if you have practiced on calculations, you would know that 450 is like 75 into 6. Again, this is like split and merge only. Basically, we are trying to split 450 as a multiple of 75. So I get to know that 450 is 75 into 6. Yes or no? And we also know that 75 is 10%. So I'll replace this 10%. 10% into 6 is how much? 60%. That's your answer. And you will not be writing all this on paper. Remember, you will do this mentally. Clear to all of you? So cut down the number of steps. The whole idea is to, you know, write as less as possible on paper there so that you can save your precious time. Right? So 10% into 6, 60% should be the answer. All right? 125.5 plus 242.75 plus this x into 6 by 7 equals to 480. So the first thing that we would do is, you know, take this 6 by 7 on the other side. And you know, when you write 6 by 7 on the other side, or take it on the other side, it becomes 7 by 6. You're getting it? It becomes 7 by 6. Or
If you are comfortable, you can directly cancel 6 with 480 here, or you can cancel 480 with 6 directly, right? Anyway, so what I'll do is I'll write it as 7 by 6. You getting it? Into 6 by 7, then goes to the other side, becomes 7 by 6. Now, 6 goes how many times? 80 times. 80 into 7 is 560. So very clearly we know that the right hand side now is 560, right? I'll just write what is left out. 125.5 plus 242.75 plus question mark is equal to 560. Now just do that addition, subtraction, arithmetic calculation and find out what comes in place of question mark. So you know the answer would be 560 minus 125.5 minus 242.75. Now if you start adding these numbers on paper, like what usually we do when you were in school, right? 242.75. So first add these numbers. So what do we get? 5, then this is like 12, 7 and 1, 8, 6 and 3, 368.25. And then if you say that the answer is 560 minus 368.25. And again, if you subtract 560 minus 368.25 on paper, I'm just trying to show you what is usually done, right? So you would show that this is like 5, this is 9, this is 9 and this is 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 2 is 7, this is 1, this will be 15 minus 6, which is 9, and 4 minus 3 is 1. So 191.75. If by any chance you have done these two calculations on paper to get the answer as 191.75, let me, you know, wash your eyes. Answer is right. 191.75 is the correct answer, but the method is wrong. Now you might be wondering, why is the method wrong? Well, nothing wrong with the method, but just think about it. Can you do all this in the exam? Can you, do you have enough time to put pen on paper and do all these calculations? Not really. But most of us end up doing this. And that is what we need to change, right? So the idea is to add these numbers mentally, right? You should be able to do these calculations without having to put pen on paper, all right? So what do we do? See, adding 125.5 with 242.75 might be difficult for many of us. But then, if you split these numbers intelligently, finding out the sum will become very easy. Like for example, 100 plus 200. You know that this is 100, this is 200, 300, 20 plus 40 is 60, 5 plus 2 is 7. So 300 plus 60 plus 7, how much is that? 367. Now 0.5 and 0.75 is 1.25. Yes or no? 0.5 and 0.75 is 1.25. You already have 367 plus 1.25. It is 368.25. So you can say that this is going to be 368.25. In fact, you need to write 368.25 on paper. You should do it mentally and remember the value. So question mark will be what? 560 minus 368.25. So you see this part of calculation that you have done on paper is not needed. You're getting me? See, why am I asking you not to put pen on paper for this one? By the time you write 125.5 here, you have spent about 2 seconds, right? Then you write 242.75, another 2 seconds. So basically 4 to 5 seconds are gone and only writing the numbers again on paper, which is a clear waste of time, right? You're killing your time here. And then you do it step by step, which is of no use in my view, right? It makes no sense. Now double is the subtraction part of it. How do you do it? Again, doing it this way is not the best way. So what do you do? Try to do it mentally. See, 560 minus 368.25. Subtracting it straight may be difficult, but try to split it into parts. Like for example, we can say that this 368.25 is like 360 plus 8.25. Again, you don't have to write this, but just visualize this, right? Just try to understand this mentally. So 368.25 is like 360 plus 8.25. Now what do you do? 560 minus 360, right? First subtract 360. 560 minus 360 is 200. 200 minus 8.25. 200 minus 8.25. So it's like 200 minus 8. Answer should be close to 192. Immediately look at the options. There's only one option which is close to 192 here. You know that it cannot be 172, 219. Okay, 189 also looks close to 192, but it cannot be so less, right? 192 point plus or minus point something, right? So it cannot go to 189, right? And 211 again is clearly out of the range there. So answer has to be 191.75.